Hello, good morning students of class 9. Today I am going to teach you the text. Previous day I had given you the summary of your poem, The Lake Isle of Innisfree, written by William Butler Yeats, W.B. Yeats. After completing the summary, now I am going to read the text line by line. It is written that I will arise and go not and go to Innisfree and a small cabin built there of clay and wattles met. 9 bee rows will I have there, a hive for the honey bee, and live alone in the bee loud glade. Come to the meaning. Arise means stand up. Innisfree is considered a pure island where clean nature and healthy beauty coexist. Cabin, a small shelter is called cabin. Wattles, twisted sticks for making fence, is called wattles. Glade, an opening in the forest. Bee loud, the buzzing of the bees. The speaker, the poet, says that he will arise and soon he is going to Innisfree. Innisfree is a small island in the lake called Lough Gill in Sligo County, Ireland. As a young boy, he often went to the island. There he will build a small wooden shelter in the small opening in the woods, in the forest. And it's going to be quite simple and rusty, bare of furniture. He didn't want any modern furniture. He will make it of clay and wattles. This is an ancient construction technique where a clay is smeared over a frame of interwoven branches. He is also going to have a garden with 9 beams planted in a row and a beehive for honeybee. The speaker informs that he desires to live alone, surrounded only by the sounds made by the bees, and be with Innisfree. Come to the second stanza. And I shall have some peace there, for peace comes dropping slow, dropping from the veils of morning to where the cricket sings. There midnight's all a glimmer and noon a purple glow and evening full of the linnet's wings. Peace, silence, dropping slow, dropping in low motion, veils, mask or silk that covers the faces. Literally, a piece of fine material to conceal the face, it is called veil. Cricket, an insect related to the grasshopper. All a glimmer, shining brightly. Linnet is mainly brown and grey, finch with a reddish breast. Glow, light reflected by the sun on the heather makes the island appear bright purple. The first line gives a clue why he wants to build a little cabin in an isolated island with very little habitation. However, in peace comes dropping slow indicates he is restless and too busy. Maybe that is why he wants to spend his time to break away from the hustle and bustle of the urban life. He was fed up with urban life, urban style, living lifestyle. He is nostalgic about the morning hour in the island when the daylight breaks in gradually to keep peace and calm and peace of the quiet countryside. The speaker says that mist of fog, that veil of morning are lifted once when the sun rises. The morning soon is filled with the sounds of the cricket chirping in the surroundings. He quotes peace to nature. It seems the midnight look beautiful. It may also indicate the blissful calm. The speaker says that evening is a sight to behold, as it is filled by flocks of linnet's wings, homeward bound. It makes us think it's not one bird, but lots of them in flight. That's why sky is full of linnet's wings. Third stanza. I will arise and go now, for always, night and day, I hear the lake water lapping with low sounds by the shore, while I stand on the roadway or on the pavement grey. I hear it in the deep heart's core. Come to the meaning. Lapping sound of water striking the coastal shore. Roadway, concrete in the urban settlement, pavement grey. The walkway seems to have discolored because of excess of walking. Deep heart score in the depth of one's heart. The poet says that the speaker is more than determined to go ahead with his decision to go to Innisfree. He imagines he can hear the lapping of the water reaching the shore. He wants to hear the sound of lapping of water reaching to the shore. The use of auditory image as a metaphor shows his strong desire to get to the place of his dreams. However, he can't be far from Innisfree, as in his mind and heart, he hears the lapping of the water hit the shore as he actually standing on the parched grey road or in the city. The last line confirms that all is in his imagination, since the heart cannot actually be here. We might think the deep heart's core is a metaphor, as it is speaking of the poet's deepest feeling and dreams. Though he is in the city, his heart and minds are living in Innisfree. So, the Lake Ijal of Innisfree utilizes the rhythm in an the rhyming scheme of the poem is ABAB. This means that the end of the first line of the stanza rhymes with the end of the third line, and the end of the second line of the stanza rhymes with the end of the fourth line. All three of the criterion is the Lake of Innisfree displays an ABAB rhyme scheme. So this is the poem written by W. B. Yeats, in which he expresses his desire to spend some time in the lap of nature because he is fed up spending his time in metropolitan cities, and he has very smartly portrayed the beautiful things present in our nature. This is the ending of the poem. Thanking all of you. Have a nice day.